Hi, in this video, I'm going to explain about exercise 8.1, chapter 8, binomial theorem, question number 6, 7, 8 and 9 solution. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Using binomial theorem, evaluate each of the following. Question number 6, 96 to the power 3. See, here to evaluate any value using binomial theorem, we need two variables. But in this case, we have only the value 96 to the power 3. In such situations, we can write the value in terms of 100. That means this 96 now I can write as 100 minus 4 to the power 3. We are taking here 100 because 100 to the power values can be written easily without any calculation. That is the reason that by using 100 we can write these values. So 96 to the power 3 can be written as 100 minus 4 to the power 3. Now here we have two variables. So based on these two variables we can find the x value as well as y value. So if you compare this with this binomial theorem, here I have written the binomial theorem for negative values, because here we have a negative sign. So now x can be 100, y value is equal to 4 and n value is equal to 3. Now to these values write the expansion of the binomial theorem. That is nc0 means 3c0. We have to start from 3c0 and we need to end up to ncn. So 3c0, 3c1, 3c2, 3c3. Then here x value, the x value power is decreasing. It starts from n. So here n is 3. So 100 to the power 3, 100 to the power 2, 100, and here it is 100 to the power 0, which is 1. So that's why I have not written that. Next, again, the second power, that is second variable, is 4. The power of the second variable is increasing. So here it is y to the power 0, that is 4 to the power 0, which is 1, 4, then 4 square and 4 cube. And here we have a negative value, so that's why here we have to put a negative sign. For the first term it is positive, second term negative, third term is positive, fourth term is negative. Like this way it continues, and at last, depending on the power value, the sign value changes. See, here we have to the power 3, so minus 1 to the power 3, it is an odd number. So if you have an odd power, that means it is a negative sign, and if you have an even power, then it is a positive sign. So now here we have the expansion. So for this we need to find out the value of 3c0, 3c1, 3c2 and 3c3. These values we can find out easily by using these formulas. See, we know that nc0 is equal to ncn, that is equal to 1. So from this we can find the value of 3c0 is equal to 1. In the same way, 3c3 is equal to 1. Then next, here we know that nc1, ncn minus 1 is equal to n. So from this we can get the value of these two, that is 3c1 is equal to 3. Then ncn minus 1, that is 3c2. So 3c2 is equal to, that is 3 minus 1, which is 2. So 3c2 is equal to 3. Then 3c2 value you can find out by using the formula n factorial divided by n minus r whole factorial into r factorial. So here we get 3 factorial divided by 3 minus 2 whole factorial into 2 factorial, that is equal to 3 into 2 into 1, this is 1 factorial, 1 into 2 into 1. After cancellation, here we get the value 3. So now we got the value for all the combination values. So just replace the value in the expansion. So here we have 1 into 100 to the power cube minus 3 into 100 square into 4 plus 3 into 100 into 4 square minus 1 into 4 cube. Now here we have 100 to the power cube. So this we can write, instead of multiplying the values directly, you can write, see here we have 100 to the power 3, that means 100 you need to write 3 times. So here I have written, see this 0, 0 you have to write 3 number of times, double 0, that is 0, 0, 1, 2, 3. That is nothing but 100 to the power 3. Directly you can write instead of calculating. Then 3 into 4, that is 12, then 100 square. Means here this double 0 you have to write 2 number of times, so 00 once and 00 twice. Next, 3 into 4 square. 4 square is 16. 16 into 3, that is 48. 48 into 100. Then minus 4 cube, that is 64. Minus 64. So now here we have the value. After subtracting and adding, finally we get the answer 884736. Next here we will see question number 7. The question number 7 is similar question. So question number 7 is 102 to the power 5. Again here see, this we have to write in terms of 100. 102 we can write as 100 plus 2, which is nothing but 102. Now this is in the form of binomial theorem. That is, we can consider here two variables, one as x, another one as y. So here we have a plus symbol, that means we can use this binomial theorem, x plus y to the power n. Now compare this value with this and find the value of x. X is here 100, y is here 2, and n is equal to 5. So now based on these values, write the expansion of this 100 plus 2 to the power 5. So here we have to start from nc0 and up to ncn. So we have to start here from 5c0, 5c1, 5c2, 5c3, 5c4 and 5c5. After that, the first variable is x to the power x here, x to the power n. It starts from x to the power n and up to x to the power 0. So here x is 100, so 100 to the power 5, 100 to the power 4, 100 to the power 3, 100 square, 100, and here it is 100 to the power 0. Next, again the second variable, that is y, the second variable power is increasing, so here it is 2, so 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 3, 2 to the power 4, and 2 to the power 5. Now this is the expansion for this. Now here we first we need to find the value of combination, that is 5c0, 5c1 and all these values. So to find the values we can use these formulas. See, based on this formula, nc0 is equal to 1 as well as ncn is equal to 1, we can find the value of 5c0, that is equal to 1, and 5c5, that is equal to 1. This I got by using this formula. Next, NC1 is equal to N in the same way NCN minus 1 is equal to N. So using these two formulas, we can get the value of this. That is 5C1 is equal to N, that means 5, and 5C4 is equal to 5. Then next, again, here we need to find the value of 5C2. So 5C2 value you can find out by using the formula, that is N factorial divided by N minus R whole factorial into R factorial, which is 5 factorial divided by 5 minus 2 whole factorial into 2 factorial, that is 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 2 factorial, which is equal to 5 into 4 into 3 factorial. I will stop here only instead of writing all the expansion, because in the denominator we have 3 factorial, so this we can cancel with this into 2 into 1. So after cancellation and multiplying, finally we get the answer 10. Next, again here we need the value of 5c3. So instead of calculating the value of 5c3, we can use this formula. That is, NCR is equal to NCN minus R. So 5c3 is equal to 5C N minus R, that is 5 minus 3, which is equal to 5C2. So 5C3 is equal to 5C2. From this formula, we know the value of 5C2, that is 10. So we can say that now 5C3 is also is equal to 10. That is from this formula. Now we got the value for all the combinations. So just substitute the values in the expansion. So here we have 5C0, that is 1 into 100 to the power 5 plus 5 into 100 to the power 4 into 2 plus 10 into 100 cube into 2 square plus 10 into 100 square into 2 cube plus 5 into 100 into 2 to the power 4 plus 1 into 2 to the power 5. Now here write the power values. See, 100 to the power 5, that means this double 100, you double 0 you have to write 5 times. So 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then 5 into 2, that is 10. Then 100 to the power 4, that means this double 0 you have to write 4 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Then 10 into 2 square, that is 40. So 100 to the power cube, that means 1, 2, 3. Then 10 into 2 cube, that is 2 cube is 88. 8 into 10, which is 80. Then 100 square, that will be 10000. Then plus 5 into 2 to the power 4, then this becomes 80, 80 into 100 plus 32. Now after adding, finally we get the answer 11040808032. Next, again here we will see question number 8. Question number 8 is 101 to the power 4. Again here this value we have to write in terms of 100 so that we can apply the binomial theorem. So we can write 101 as 100 plus 1. So now here we have two variables, x as well as y. Now for this you can apply the binomial theorem. So the binomial theorem is x plus y to the power n, because here we have the plus sign. Now compare this value with this so that we can get the x value as 100, y value as 1 and n value as 4. Now let us write the binomial theorem expansion for this value 100 plus 1 to the power 4. So we have to start from 4c0 up to 4cn, that is 4c4. So 4c0, 4c1, 4c2, 4c3 and 4c4. Next, the first variable value we have to start from 4 and we need to go till 0. So 100 to the power 4, 100 to the power 3, 100 to the power 2, 100, and here it is 100 to the power 0, that is 1. Next, the second variable value we need to start from 0 and we have to go up to 4. So 1 to the power 0, that is 1 only, 1, 1 square, 1 cube and 1 to the power 4. Now this is the expansion for this particular value. Now for this we need to find the value of combinations. So we can find the value of combinations by using this formula. See, NC0 and NCn, both of these values is equal to 1. So from this we can get that 4C0 is equal to 1 and 4C4 is equal to 1. Next, again NC1 is equal to NCn minus 1. Both of these values are is equal to n. So from this we can find these two values, 4C1 is equal to 4 and 4C3 is equal to 4. Next, let us find the value of 4C2. To find the value of this, we can use the formula, that is NCr is equal to n factorial divided by n minus r whole factorial into r factorial. N factorial is here 4 factorial divided by n minus r 4 minus 2 whole factorial into 2 factorial, that is equal to 4 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 2 factorial. So here 4 into 3 into 2 factorial, I will stop up to here. Then here we have 2 factorial, so this and this you can cancel. After cancellation and multiplying, finally we get the answer of 4c2 as 6. So now we got the values for all the combination values. So just substitute the values in the expansion. So this becomes 100 plus 1 to the power 4 is equal to 1 into 100 to the power 4 plus 4 into 100 cube into 1 plus 6 into 100 square into 1 square plus 4 into 100 into 1 cube plus 1 into 1 to the power 4. So I just substituted these values in the expansion. Next, again here 100 to the power 4 directly we can write. Here we have double 0. Double 0 you need to write 4 times, because here we have 4. So once, twice, then thrice and 4th times I have written. Next, 4 into 100 to the power 3. So 100 double 0 you have to write 3 times, 1, 2, 3. Then 6 into 100 square, that is 10000. Then 4 into 100, then plus 1. Now after adding, finally we get the answer 10406040401. Next, 9th question, 99 to the power 5. Again, this we have to first write in terms of 100. So this 99 we can write as 100 minus 1 to the power 5. This is in the form x minus y to the power n, because here we have a negative sign. So now we have to use this binomial theorem. So now by comparing this with this, find the value of x. X is equal to 100, y is equal to 1 and n is equal to 5. Now let us write the expansion 100 minus 1 to the power 5. So we have to start from 5, 5c0. 5C1, 5C2, 5C3, 5C4 and up to 5C5. Then the first variable is 100 here. This power starts from 5. So 100 to the power 5, 100 to the power 4, 100 cube, 100 square, 100. And here it is 100 to the power 0, which is 1. Then the second variable power starts from 0. So 1 to the power 0, that is 1. 1 to the power 1, here it is 1 square, 1 cube, 1 to the power 4, 1 to the power 5. Then here we have a negative sign. So we have to put the sign. First we have to put plus sign, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. The last sign depending on the power value, that is here we have to the power 5, that means minus 1 to the power 5. So here it is an odd number. Odd number means here last value, here it is negative. The last value sign is negative. Then now let us find the value of combinations, that is 5C0, 5C5 can be written as 1 because by using this formula. Then NC1 is equal to NCN minus 1. So from this we can get the value of these. 5C1 is equal to 5 and 5C4 is equal to 5. Then again 5C2, to find the value of 5C2 we can use the formula n factorial divided by n minus r whole factorial into r factorial. So we get here 5 factorial divided by 5 minus 2 whole factorial into 2 factorial, that is equal to 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 2 factorial, that is equal to 5 into 4 into 3 factorial. I will stop here only instead of writing the whole expansion, so that in the denominator we have 3 factorial. We can cancel this value with this into 2 into 1. So after cancellation and multiplying, finally we get the answer 10. Next, we need to find the value of 5C3. Instead of finding the value of 5C3 by using this formula, you can even use this formula. See, NCR is equal to NCN minus R. That means 5C3 we can write as 5C5 minus 3. This is equal to 5C2. So from this we got that 5C3 is equal to 5C2, and we know the value of 5C2, that is equal to 10. So that means we can say that 5C3 is also is equal to 10. Now we got the values for all the combinations. So just substitute the values in the expansion, that is 1 into 100 to the power 5 minus 5 into 100 to the power 4 into 1 plus 10 into 100 cube into 1 square minus 10 into 100 square into 1 cube plus 5 into 100 into 1 to the power 4 minus 1 into 1 to the power 5. Now here find the power values. Here we have 100 to the power 5, that means 00, no need to perform the multiplication, directly you can write here 00, you have to write 5 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then minus 5 into 100 to the power 4, so this 00 you have to write 4 times, then plus 10 into 100 to the power 3, so this 00 write 3 times. Then we have minus 10 into 100 square, that is 10000 plus 5 into 100 minus 1. So after adding and subtracting, finally we get the answer as 95099000499. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Also click the bell icon to get more regular updates. Thanks for watching.